Go live complete. And I'm about to hit broadcast.
Yep, I got the Facebook notification that we're live. So
we're on. Assalamu alaikum, everyone. We will just wait a couple minutes and we'll get started. Okay, assalamu alaikum. We're going to get started with this Friday's program. We'll start off with the recitation of Surah Kahf by Hafiz Naveed Iqbal, followed by a Friday message by Dr. Muzammil Siddiqi with the title of Ramadan during COVID. Hafiz Naveed, if you want to go ahead and share your video, and then we'll get started. Hafiz Naveed, if you can share your video, please.
I'm trying to share, but he said you stopped it. The host stopped.
Oh, okay. There we go. Can you?
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب ولم يجعل له عوجا قيما لينذر بأسا شديدا من لدنه ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا حسنا ماكثين فيه أبدا وإنذرهم كبرت كلمة تخرج من أفواههم إن يقولون إلا كذبا فلعلك باخع نفسك على آثارهم إن لم يؤمنوا بهذا الحديث أسفا إنا جعلنا ما على الأرض زينة لها لنبلوهم أيهم أحسن عملا وإنا لجاعلون ما عليها صعيدا جرزا أم حسبت أن أصحاب الكهف والرقيم كانوا من آياتنا عجبا إذ أوى الفتية إلى الكهف فقالوا ربنا آتنا من لدنك رحمة وهيئ لنا من أمرنا رشدا فضربنا على آذانهم في الكهف سنين عددا ثم بعثناهم لنعلم أي الحزبين أحصى لما لبثوا أمدا نحن نقص عليك نبأهم بالحق إنهم فتية آمنوا بربهم وزدناهم هدى وَرَبَطْنَا عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ إِذْ قَامُوا فَقَالُوا رَبُّنَا رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ لَن نَّدْعُوَ مِن دُونِهِ إِلَٰهًا لَّقَدْ قُلْنَا إِذًا شَطَطًا هَٰؤُلَاءِ قَوْمُنَا اتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِهِ آلِهَةً لَّوْلَا يَأْتُونَ عَلَيْهِم بِسُلْطَانٍ بَيِّنٍ فَمَن أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنِ افْتَرَىٰ عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا وَإِذِ اعْتَزَلْتُمُوهُمْ وَمَا يَعْبُدُونَ إِلَّا اللَّهَ فَأْوُوا إِلَى الْكَهْفِ يَنشُرْ لَكُمْ رَبُّكُم مِّن رَّحْمَتِهِ وَيُهَيِّئْ لَكُم مِّنْ أَمْرِكُم مِّرْفَقًا وَتَرَى الشَّمْسَ إِذَا طَلَعَت تَّزَاوَرُ عَن كَهْفِهِمْ ذَاتَ الْيَمِينِ وَإِذَا غَرَبَت تَّقْرِضُهُمْ ذَاتَ الشِّمَالِ وَهُمْ فِي فَجْوَةٍ مِّنْهُ ذَٰلِكَ مِنْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ مَن يَهْدِ اللَّهُ فَهُوَ الْمُهْتَدِ وَمَن يُضْلِلْ فَلَن تجد له وليا مرشدا وتحسبهم أيقاظا وهم قالوا لبثنا يوما أو بعض يوم قالوا ربكم أعلم بما لبثتم فابعثوا أحدكم بورقكم هذه إلى المدينة فلينظر أيها أزكى طعاما فليأتكم برزق منه وليتلطف ولا يشعرن بكم أحدا إنهم إن يظهروا عليكم يرجموكم أو يعيدوكم في ملتهم ولن تفلحوا إذا أبدا وكذلك أعثرنا عليهم ليعلموا أن وعد الله حق وأن الساعة لا ريب فيها إذ يتنازعون بينهم أمرهم فقالوا ابنوا عليهم بنيانا ربهم أعلم بهم قال الذين غلبوا على أمرهم لنتخذن عليهم مسجدا سيقولون ثلاثة رابعهم كلبهم ويقولون خمسة سادسهم كلبهم رجما بالغيب ويقولون سبعة وثامنهم كلبهم قل ربي أعلم بعدتهم ما يعلمهم إلا قليل فلا تمار فيهم إلا مراء ظاهرا ولا تستفت فيهم منهم أحدا ولا تقولن لشيء إني فاعل ذلك غدا إلا أن يشاء الله واذكر ربك إذا نسيت وقل عسى أن يهديني ربي لأقرب من هذا رشدا ولبثوا في كهفهم 300 سنين وازدادوا 9 قل الله أعلم بما لبثوا له غيب السماوات والأرض أبصر به وأسمع ما لهم من دونه من ولي ولا يشرك في حكمه أحدا واتل ما أوحي إليك من كتاب ربك لا مبدل لكلماته ولن تجد من دونه ملتحدا واصبر نفسك مع الذين يدعون ربهم بالغداة والعشي يريدون وجهه ولا تعد عيناك عنهم تريد زينة الحياة الدنيا ولا تطع من أغفلنا قلبه عن ذكرنا واتبع هواه وكان أمره فرطا وقل الحق من ربكم فمن شاء فليؤمن ومن شاء فليكفر إنا أعتدنا للظالمين نارا أحاط بهم سرادقها وإن يستغيثوا يغاثوا بماء كالمهل يشوي الوجوه بئس الشراب وساءت مرتفقا إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات إنتين من أعناب وحففناهما بنخل وجعلنا بينهما زرعا كلتا الجنتين آتت أكلها ولم تظلم منه شيئا وفجرنا خلالهما نهرا وكان له ثمر فقال لصاحبه وهو يحاوره أنا أكثر منك مالا وأعز نفرا ودخل جنته وهو ظالم لنفسه قال ما أظن أن تبيد هذه أبدا وما أظن الساعة قائمة ولئن رددت إلى ربي لأجدن خيرا منها منقلبا قال له صاحبه وهو يحاوره أكفرت بالذي خلقك من تراب ثم من نطفة ثم سواك رجلا لكن هو الله ربي ولا أشرك بربي أحدا ولولا إذ دخلت جنتك قلت ما شاء الله لا قوة إلا بالله إن ترني أنا أقل منك مالا وولدا فعسى ربي أن يؤتيني خيرا من جنتك ويرسل عليها حسبانا ويرسل عليها حسبانا من السماء فتصبح صعيدا زلقا أو يصبح ماؤها غورا فلن تستطيع له طلبا وأحيط بثمره فأصبح يقلب كفيه على ما أنفق فيها وهي خاوية على عروشها ويقول يا ليتني لم أشرك بربي أحدا ولم تكن له فئة ينصرونه من دون الله وما كان منتصرا هنالك الولاية لله الحق هو خير ثوابا وخير عقبا واضرب لهم مثل الحياة الدنيا كما إن أنزلناه من السماء فاختلط به نبات الأرض فأصبح هشيما تذروه الرياح وكان الله على كل شيء مقتدرا المال والبنون زينة الحياة الدنيا والباقيات الصالحات خير عند ربك ثوابا وخير أملا ويوم نسير الجبال وترى الأرض بارزة وحشرناهم فلم نغادر منهم أحدا وعرضوا على ربك صفا لقد جئتمونا كما خلقناكم أول مرة بل زعمتم أن لن نجعل لكم موعدا ووضع الكتاب فترى المجرمين مشفقين مما فيه ويقولون يا ويلتنا ما لهذا الكتاب لا يغادر صغيرة ولا كبيرة إلا أحصاها ووجدوا ما عملوا حاضرا ولا يظلم ربك أحدا وإذ قلنا للملائكة اسجدوا لآدم فسجدوا إلا إبليس كان من الجن ففسق عن أمر ربه أفتتخذونه وذريته أولياء من دوني وهم لكم عدو بئس للظالمين بدلا ما أشهدتهم خلق السماوات والأرض ولا خلق أنفسهم وما كنت متخذ المضلين عضدا ويوم يقول نادوا شركائي الذين زعمتم فدعوهم فلم يستجيبوا لهم وجعلنا بينهم موبقا ورأى المجرمون النار فظنوا أنهم مواقعوها ولم يجدوا عنها مصرفا ولقد صرفنا في هذا القرآن للناس من كل مثل وكان الإنسان أكثر شيء جدلا وما منع الناس أن يؤمنوا إذ جاءهم الهدى ويستغفروا ربهم إلا أن تأتيهم سنة الأولين أو يأتيهم العذاب قبلا وما نرسل المرسلين إلا مبشرين ومنذرين ويجادل الذين كفروا بالباطل ليدحضوا به الحق واتخذوا آياتي وما أنذروا هزوا ومن أظلم ممن ذكر بآيات ربه فأعرض عنها ونسي ما قدمت يداه إنا جعلنا على قلوبهم أكنة أن يفقهوه وفي آذانهم وقرا وإن تدعهم إلى الهدى فلن يهتدوا إذا أبدا وربك الغفور ذو الرحمة لو يؤاخذهم بما كسبوا لعجل لهم العذاب بل لهم موعد لن يجدوا من دونه موئلا وتلك القرى أهلكناهم لما ظلموا وجعلنا لمهلكهم موعدا وإذ قال موسى لفتاه لا أبرح حتى أبلغ مجمع البحرين أو أمضي حقبا فلما بلغا مجمع بينهما نسيا حوتهما فاتخذ سبيله في البحر سربا فلما جاوزا قال لفتاه آتنا غداءنا لقد لقينا من سفرنا هذا نصبا قال أرأيت إذ أويت إلى الصخرة فإني نسيت الحوت وما أنسانيه إلا الشيطان أن أذكره واتخذ سبيله في البحر عجبا قال ذلك ما كنا نبغي فارتدا على آثارهما قصصا فوجدا عبدا من عبادنا آتيناه رحمة من عندنا وعلمناه من لدنا علما قال له موسى هل أتبعك على أن تعلمني مما علمت رشدا قال إنك لن تستطيع معي صبرا وكيف تصبر على ما لم تحط به خبرا قال ستجدني إن شاء الله صابرا ولا أعصي لك أمرا قال فإن اتبعتني فلا تسألني عن شيء حتى أحدث لك منه ذكرا فانطلقا حتى إذا ركبا في السفينة خرقها قال أخرقتها لتغرق أهلها لقد جئت شيئا إمرا قال ألم أقل إنك لن تستطيع معي صبرا قال لا تؤاخذني بما نسيت ولا ترهقني من أمري عسرا فانطلقا حتى إذا لقيا غلاما فقتله قال أقتلت نفسا زكية بغير نفس لقد جئت شيئا نكرا قال ألم أقل لك إنك لن تستطيع معي صبرا قال إن سألتك عن شيء بعدها فلا تصاحبني قد بلغت من لدني عذرا فانطلقا حتى إذا أتيا أهل قرية استطعما أهلها فأبوا أن يضيفوهما فوجدا فيها جدارا يريد أن ينقض فأقامه قال لو شئت لاتخذت عليه أجرا قال هذا فراق بيني وبينك سأنبئك بتأويل ما لم تستطع عليه صبرا أما السفينة فكانت لمساكين يعملون في البحر فأردت أن أعيبها وكان وراءهم ملك يأخذ كل سفينة غصبا وأما الغلام فكان أبواه مؤمنين فخشينا أن يرهقهما طغيانا وكفرا فأردنا أن يبدلهما ربهما خيرا منه زكاة وأقرب رحما وأما الجدار فكان لغلامين يتيمين في المدينة وكان تحته كنز لهما وكان أبوهما صالحا فأراد ربك أن يبلغا أشدهما ويستخرجا كنزهما رحمة من ربك وما فعلته عن أمري ذلك تأويل ما لم تستطع عليه صبرا ويسألونك عن ذي القرنين قل سأتلو عليكم منه ذكرا إِنَّا مَكَّنَّا لَهُ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَآتَيْنَاهُ مِنْ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ سَبَبًا فَأَتْبَعَ سَبَبًا حَتَّى إِذَا بَلَغَ مَغْرِبَ الشَّمْسِ وَجَدَهَا تَغْرُبُ فِي عَيْنٍ حَمِئَةٍ وَوَجَدَ عِندَهَا قَوْمًا قُلْنَا يَا ذَا الْقَرْنَيْنِ إِمَّا أَنْ تُعَذِّبَ وَإِمَّا أَنْ تَتَّخِذَ فِيهِمْ حُسْنًا قَالَ أَمَّا مَنْ ظَلَمَ فَسَوْفَ نُعَذِّبُهُ ثُمَّ يُرَدُّ إِلَى رَبِّهِ فَيُعَذِّبُهُ عَذَابًا نُكْرًا وَأَمَّا مَنْ آمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَلَهُ جَزَاءً الْحُسْنَى وَسَنَقُولُ لَهُ مِنْ أَمْرِنَا يُسْرًا ثُمَّ أَتْبَعَ سَبَبًا حَتَّى إِذَا بَلَغَ مَطْلِعَ الشَّمْسِ وَجَدَهَا تَطْلُعُ عَلَى قَوْمٍ لَّمْ نَجْعَل لَّهُم مِّن دُونِهَا سِتْرًا كَذَٰلِكَ وَقَدْ أَحَطْنَا بِمَا لَدَيْهِ خُبْرًا ثُمَّ أَتْبَعَ سَبَبًا حتى إذا بلغ بين السدين وجد من دونهما قوما لا يكادون يفقهون قولا قالوا يا ذا القرنين إن يأجوج ومأجوج مفسدون في الأرض فهل نجعل لك خرجا على أن تجعل بيننا وبينهم سدا قال ما مكنني فيه ربي خير فأعينوني بقوة أجعل بينكم وبينهم ردما آتوني زبر الحديد حتى إذا ساوى بين الصدفين قال انفخوا حتى إذا جعله نارا قال آتوني أفرغ عليه قطرا فما استطاعوا أن يظهروه وما استطاعوا له نقبا قال هذا رحمة من ربي فإذا جاء وعد ربي جعله دكاء وكان وعد ربي حقا وتركنا بعضهم يومئذ يموج في بعض ونفخ في الصور فجمعناهم جمعا وعرضنا جهنم يومئذ للكافرين عرضا الذين كانت أعينهم في غطاء عن ذكري وكانوا لا يستطيعون سمعا أفحسب الذين كفروا أن يتخذوا عبادي من دوني أولياء إنا أعتدنا جهنم للكافرين نزلا قل هل ننبئكم بالأخسرين أعمالا الذين ضل سعيهم في الحياة الدنيا وهم يحسبون أنهم يحسنون صنعا أولئك الذين كفروا بآيات ربهم ولقائه فحبطت أعمالهم فلا نقيم لهم يوم القيامة وزنا ذلك جزاؤهم جهنم بما كفروا واتخذوا آياتي ورسلي هزوا إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات كانت لهم جنات الفردوس نزلا خالدين فيها لا يبغون عنها حولا قل لو كان البحر مدادا لكلمات ربي لنفد البحر قبل أن تنفد كلمات ربي ولو جئنا بمثله مددا قل إنما أنا بشر مثلكم يوحى إلي أنما إلهكم إله واحد فمن كان يرجو لقاء ربه فليعمل عملا صالحا ولا يشرك بعبادة ربه أحدا.
جزاك الله خير بارك الله فيك. السلام عليكم. A few announcements of our upcoming events online, inshallah. Tonight's MYG program, Ramadan in Quarantine with Sheikh Shahid Ali, an at-home guide for getting the Ramadan vibe. Tune in on YouTube or Facebook Live only. Fear class with Sheikh Shahid Ali will be concluding with the summary of the Battle of Tabuk and the passing of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The class will begin at 10:30 a.m. Sunday Tafsir with Dr. Muzammil Siddiqi continues every Sunday at noon. Every Tuesday and Thursday at 6:30 p.m., Brother Ahmed Al-Mutawa will discuss heroes from Islamic history, a youth class for ages 10 to 15 in collaboration with OCS. Ramadan announcements to look forward to. The first night of Taraweeh prayers at home will be on Thursday, April 23rd. The first day of fasting will be Friday, April 24th, inshallah. On Monday, April 20th at 8 p.m., ISOC Chairman Hassan Himbubazi and Master President Hassan Siddiqi will host a webinar detailing ISOC's plans for this Ramadan. ISOC will host its Ramadan fundraiser on Saturday, May 9th. Dr. Siddiqi, Imam Siraj Wahed, and Imam Sohaib Webb will join us online. Stay tuned for upcoming event details. On Sunday, May 3rd, Dr. Siddiqi will have a Zakat seminar at noon through Zoom. For any questions or assistance, please contact us at 714-531-1722 or you can email at office@isocmasjid.org. And please donate generously at give.isocmasjid.org. Jum'ah message for today, Ramadan during COVID-19 by Dr. Muzammil Siddiqi.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن الا وانتم مسلمون يا ايها الذين امنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم اعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما الله سبحانه وتعالى bless all of you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove the difficulties of this time from all of us and from all humanity. We are approaching the blessed month of Ramadan. Inshallah, next Friday will be the fourth day of this blessed month. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the blessed month of Ramadan in the Quran, in Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah says, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم ومن كان مريضا او على سفر فعدة من ايام اخر يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون واذا سالك عبادي عني فاني قريب اجيب دعوة الداع اذا دعان فليستجيبوا لي وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون. Beautiful way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had described this month. The month of Ramadan is the month in which the Quran was sent down, a guidance for mankind. Clear signs of guidance and a criterion to judge between the right and wrong. So whosoever is present in this month must fast. And those who are sick and or on journey, fast other days. Allah wants ease for you. Allah does not want hardship for you. So you can complete the number of days of fasting and glorify Allah, magnify Allah, and be thankful to Allah. And when my servant asks you about me, I am near. I answer the calls of those who call me. So let them answer my call and believe in me so that they may be guided. This month of Ramadan is the ninth month of the lunar calendar. It is the month of Quran. Allah sent down the Quran in this month, the book of guidance for whole mankind. And it is a month of a special blessing for the believers. It is the month that brings lot of goodness for the whole world. And we are in need of that very much. We are in need of always Allah's mercy and Allah's blessings. But this is a special time. This is the time when the humanity is suffering. So it is coming at a very, very needed time. And we take full advantage of that, took full benefit of this time. Rasulullah ﷺ used to give the good news of the coming of the month of Ramadan to his Sahaba, to his companions. And he used to tell them, Atakum Ramadan. Ramadan has come to you. Shahrun Mubarak. It is the blessed month. Fihi laylatun khairun min alf shahr. In this month, there is a night that is better than 1,000 months. Faradallahu alaykum siyamahu. Allah has made it obligatory upon you to fast during this month. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens the gates of Jannah. Tuftahu abwab al-Jannah, abwab al-Sama, wa tughlaqu abwab al-Jahim, wa tughallu fihi maradat al-Shayateen. The gates of heaven are open during this month. And the gates of hell are closed. And the rebellious shayateen, the devils, are chained. So it's a very special time. And the Prophet ﷺ used to say, "Man sama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaban ghufra lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi." Those who fast during the month of Ramadan with faith and with total devotion to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seeking the reward from Allah, all their previous sins will be forgiven. And then he said, "Man qama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaban ghufra lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi." And those who pray during the night of Ramadan with iman, with faith, and with obedience to Allah, seeking the reward from Him, their previous sins also will be forgiven. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made fasting during this month obligatory upon every adult male or female who. Women, especially if they are during their menses, they fast some other days. They are not allowed to fast during this time. And all people, if they are healthy, they should fast. Somebody who is sick or somebody traveling is allowed not to fast, but they have to fast some other days. فَعِدَّةٌ مِّنْ أَيَّامٍ أُخَرٍ. So this Ramadan is coming at a time of pandemic. The whole world is suffering with pandemic. Almost 85% of the countries of the world are in a lockdown situation. And it is important to observe the direction, the instructions that we receive from the health department from our country. So we have to observe that. And these instructions are that stay home. These instructions are to have social distance. These instructions are that you have to keep yourself away from any kind of infection. Keep your hands clean, yourself clean, all of these things. So it is good to observe those, because these instructions, if they are followed properly, they will control the spread of this virus. And hopefully we'll overcome that. So our masajid, unfortunately, we are very sad to say that. It's a very difficult decision that was made. The masajid will be closed. And this is the first time in history that so many masajid will be closed, especially in the month of Ramadan. But we are in a difficult time. We are in a crisis time. And we have to manage this month, a special month. We have to manage it without masjid. So the month of Ramadan, we have to plan focusing on our homes. So this Ramadan is not focused on the masajid, but this Ramadan will be focused on home. So you plan with your family in your home, how you are going to take benefit of this month and how are you going to celebrate this month. With heavy hearts, we want to go to the masjid, five prayers, because a lot of people pray during the month of Ramadan, especially in the masajid. And they make sure that they reach to the masjid for all prayers, and especially for Taraweeh prayers, but we cannot do that. So we have to plan something else. There are five things that we should do for physical preparation. And there are five things that we should do for our spiritual preparation. The thing that we should do for our physical preparation is, first of all, prepare our home. So prepare your home for this special celebration of the month of Ramadan. Keep the home clean, organized. Maybe you put some decoration for this month. So you yourself feel like you are not only in home, but also at the masjid. And your family feel that way. It's your, especially your children feel that way. Second thing is that we have a Ramadan schedule. When to begin your fast, when to end your fast, all the other details that are there, display it in a prominent place in your home. So everybody sees that. What time you are going to start, when are you going to get up early morning, and what time you are going to break your fast, complete your fast. The third thing is that make plan for all your prayers. What time you are going to pray? Fajr prayer, what time you are going to do? Zuhr prayer, what time you are going to do? Because try to do these prayers at home in Jama'ah. Put your family together and pray together. So especially this month, don't have just prayer at any time and everybody praying on their own, but try to come together and pray together. So make a schedule for your prayers. And of course, we know the time, there is a window of time for Fajr, but you say that this is the time we're going to pray. 5 o'clock we're going to pray, or whatever, Zohar time, whatever going to pray, at time we're going to pray. So make a schedule of your time within the time of those prayers and say that this is the time when our family is going to pray. Number four is many of us, many Muslim families, they invite during the month of Ramadan their friends their family members for iftar together. Some people have a big iftar party, hold a big program for iftar, invite many people, and spend a lot of money on that. But this year you will not be able to do that. You will only hold, you have your iftar with your family, whatever number of people are there in your home, you will have iftar with them. Anyone from outside, you will not invite. So a way really to get benefits of that is that whatever money you wanted to spend, whatever money they used to spend on these iftar programs, iftar parties, try to give this money to the poor and the needy. A lot of people are in need. A lot of people are out of job. A lot of people are in difficulty. So set aside that money. Say, this is the money that I used to you for iftar program. I'm going to give it to the poor and the needy. Or give it to your charities of your choice. Or give it to your Islamic institution. Masajid are also in need. They are suffering because of that. Because donations are drying up. People used to come to the masjid, especially on Friday, and donate. But now people are home. They are not coming to the masjid. But there are people who are cleaning the masjid. There are people who are there. The staff is there. We have not let them off. So we have some expenses. And it is important to use that money. This is your charity. This is your sadaqah. This is your donation that you give it to your Islamic centers. And number five, a lot of people give their zakat during the month of Ramadan because the reward is great for giving charity in the month of Ramadan. So zakat, you can calculate it anytime during the year, but many people try to see that they pay zakat during Ramadan. And inshallah, we'll have a seminar on zakat, explaining the rules of zakat. So what you make a plan that you will give your zakat, inshallah. And also sadaqatul fitr is a special sadaqah, a special charity for the month of Ramadan. So those who can afford it, they have to pay sadaqatul fitr on behalf of their all their dependents. The head of the household pay the sadaqah, and we estimate it is about $10 per person in the family. So $10 per person in the family, that is to be given. And normally people give it on the Eid day. But during this crisis, a lot of people are in need of that. So that money can be given to the poor and the needy. A lot of people come and they ask for it, or they apply for it. The Islamic Society can distribute that money to the needy people. So these are the special preparation, physical preparation for the month of Ramadan. And then there are spiritual preparation, because this is a spiritual month. This is a month of revival of the spirit. This is a month to increase your bond with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your connection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And actually, really, this is the time we have to return to Allah. Return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala means that our mind, our feelings, our emotions, all connected to Allah. So come that way. Live with Allah during this time. Billahi wa ma'allah wa ilallah. That is the way you should plan this month. And for that, the important thing is istaghfiru rabbakum summa tubu ilayh. Make istighfar. A lot of istighfar. اللهم إني أستغفرك وأتوب إليك اللهم إني أستغفرك وأتوب إليك اللهم إني أستغفرك وأتوب إليك Oh Allah, I seek your forgiveness and I turn to you. I turn to you for your mercy, for your kindness, for your blessing, for me and for my family and for all people. أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. Repeat that. And say, لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. You know, Yunus عليه السلام, he was swallowed by the whale. And he was in the belly of the whale. And there he made this dua. Quran mentions that. He asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said that, La ilaha illa anta subhanak. There is no God except you. And you are glorified. I was wrong. We all do wrong. So ask Allah to forgive you. And this is a very special time to seek forgiveness. Allahumma innaka afuwan tuhibbul afwa fa'afu anni. Oh Allah, you are the most forgiving one. You love to forgive. Forgive me. So we all have to do that. Our collective istighfar, our individual istighfar is going to change. And going to change the situation, and Allah's blessings are going to come. Indeed, Allah's blessings are going to come. So be certain of that. Be sure this is going to happen. But you have to be sincere. And when you make istighfar, do it with attention, with sincerity. It's not that the mind is somewhere else and you're just repeating. Ask Allah to forgive you. Think about that. How many things that you have done that you should not have done? And come back to Allah. Come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that is a very important thing. The second thing is for your spiritual preparation, that plan and have the intention that you are going to fast the whole month. And you are not going to miss any day. You're going to fast as it should be done. Follow the rules of fasting and you will do that. So you make intention for the whole month. And of course, every day you have to remind yourself, refresh your intention. As we do that, I'm making intention to fast today for the sake of Allah. Allah, make it easy for me and accept it from me. So you make this intention. Make the intention that you're going to fast for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that Allah may bless you, bless your family, and accept these things from you, inshallah. And if you are sick, or you become sick during the month of Ramadan, then of course you are allowed not to fast. And then you can make it up, inshallah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you shifa when you recover from your sickness. And later, after the month of Ramadan, anytime, you can make up for those days. Fa'iddatum min ayyamin ukhar. So those who are not well, for any reason, they are not feeling well, they are sick, fever, flu, whatever, may Allah keep you away from all of these things. But if it happens, then you do not fast on that day. And fast after that. And also those people who are under great hardship because of this virus, for them also, they check with their doctors and see if the doctor says that it is not recommended for you, people who have problem, heart problem, lung problem, kidney problem, diabetes, and all those things, they should check with their doctors. And if the doctors advise them not to fast, then they don't fast. After the month of Ramadan, if they're well, they can make it up for those they miss. And if they cannot make it up because the sickness continues, then for them is fidya. وَعَلَى الَّذِينَ يُطِيقُونَهُ فِدْيَةٌ طَعَامُ مِسْكِينَ. Allah said in the Quran, those who cannot do it or they have hardship because of hardship for fasting, then they give fidya. And fidya is one day's meal for a poor person. That is two meals. The two meals you provide to a poor person and the needy person, or you can give the value of two meals. An average value, you can do that. And estimate is about $12 per day. $12 per day, that is for every day of fast that you miss. If you're missing the whole month, then you pay for the whole month. If you're missing for a few days, then do it for a few days. So that is the fidya. For those who cannot fast, who cannot make qada, cannot make it up after the month of Ramadan, then they have to give the fidya for that. And if somebody is unable to pay the fidya, they cannot afford it, then ask Allah to forgive them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, لَا يُكُلِّفُ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِلَّا وُسْعَهَا. Allah does not impose a burden on anyone beyond his or her capacity. يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرُ وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْعُسْرَ. Allah wants ease for you, Allah does not want hardship for you. So yes, there is an obligation, but the obligation is as long as you can do it. And you are capable to do that. The fourth thing that is important is that plan to pray Taraweeh prayer. Now, many of us, alhamdulillah, we go to the masjid during Ramadan and we come in very large number, mashallah, to pray Taraweeh prayers. And we listen to the recitation of the Quran. We try to listen to the whole Quran. Some of us pray 8 rak'ah, some of us pray 20 rak'ah. And try to observe that, because it is sunnah mu'akkada. It is the required sunnah. It is not just up to you, pray or not pray, but it is the required sunnah, according to most of the schools of jurisprudence. So do not miss your taraweeh. But you are not going to do that in the masjid. And it is okay to pray at home. Just like doing your other four prayers at home, so in a similar way, you do taraweeh prayers at home. Actually, Rasulullah himself prayed only 3 days. And then he said to the Sahaba, go and pray your homes. The Sahaba used to pray at home. But then after that, it became the custom, it became a tradition of Muslims to pray taraweeh prayers in the masajid. So alhamdulillah, this is a very good tradition, that if people come together and pray together in the masjid. But when you cannot go to masjid is not available, then pray at home. Now, you make jama'ah for taraweeh as well. That means one person lead the taraweeh prayer. Now you might say, I don't have a hafiz at home. So whatever surah you know, if somebody has the whole Quran and know the whole Quran, alhamdulillah. But if you don't, then what else? You may know some surahs. Recite those surahs. You can pray 8 rak'ah, you pray 20 rak'ah. And if you want, it is permissible for sunnah and the nafl prayer. If you want, you can hold the copy of the Quran in your hand and read from the Quran. And if you want, you have it, Quran app in your mobile phone, you can use that. But make sure that you are not going to go into some other program during the Salat. Because somebody send you a message, an app, and then you suddenly turn it over that avoid that. Because that will break your Salat. So no other messages, no other emails, nothing else except the Quran that you have to keep that. And so pay attention to the reading of the Quran, and as much as you can read, فَقْرَوْ مَا تَيَسَّرَ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ, whatever you can read from the Quran, you read it, and then you have to pray. You pray 8 rak'ah or you pray 20 rak'ah, you can do that. And then after that, make dua, and inshallah, there will be some programs will be zoomed from the Islamic Society, a reminder about our khatira that we give before the Salat. We'll give you the time for that. On Monday, you will hear some more details about different programs that Islamic Society will do during the month of Ramadan. So watch for that. So taraweeh prayer is very important. And then number 10 is that the month of the i'tikaf, the last 10 days of the month of Ramadan that many people spend in the masjid, that is not available. So, and i'tikaf is only in the masjid. You cannot have i'tikaf in your home. وَأَنْتُمْ عَاكِفُونَ فِي الْمَسَاجِدِ. So i'tikaf requires masjid, and if masjid is not available, then you cannot have i'tikaf. So that will not be available. The program of Laylatul Qadr that we normally hold on the 27th of Ramadan, and we have Qiyamul Layl. Actually, in the last 10 days, we have a lot of Qiyamul Layl, but those also will not be available because there is no gathering. The only gathering that is possible is the home gathering. The people in their families only. Those who live in the family, they are the one who can do that. So you can do Qiyam at your home. You can have the whole night prayers at home and make dua, pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you will hear inshallah, details of some program that will be relayed online. So watch those programs, listen to some speeches during that time. Another thing that I forgot to mention is that make sure that you read the Quran every day. Not just in Taraweeh, but your own personal reading. So have a plan for that, that you read the Quran, at least one juz, so that you finish the whole Quran in this month, and then some other azkar, some other dua, some prayer that you do, and also listen to some good lectures that are available online. There are some available on the videos. So listen to those lectures, but avoid wasting your time watching movies or unnecessary things that have no use. Avoid that. So it is not the time of entertainment. Yes, you can do exercise, physical exercise. You should do that because that is good for your fast and for your health. All of these things are important, do that. But avoid wasting time in anything else. Get sleep, but not too much. And at the same time, also spend time in the reading of the Quran, reading some good books, listening to some good lectures, and doing the zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make dua. So these are the things that we should do, inshallah, and we'll benefit from the month of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is a difficult time. There are a number of things that we used to do in Ramadan and will not be doing that. But alhamdulillah, summa alhamdulillah. Thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is nothing obligatory that we'll not be able to do. There is nothing that is required to do in the month of Ramadan. We will not be able to do. Inshallah, most of us will be able to, inshallah, fast and do that. So take advantage of what you can do. Thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you are in good health. Thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you have good homes and comfortable in your homes, because a lot of people don't have that and they're going through that. Thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you have food that you can have for suhoor or for iftar. So be very grateful to Allah. La in shakartum la azidannakum. Allah says that if you are thankful, I'll give you more. So be thankful to Allah. Devote your time to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Make more dua, make more sadaqah. All of these things, inshallah, remove this affliction, remove this musibah from us and from the humanity. May Allah bring the humanity back to Allah, to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I hope this affliction, this bala, will teach us some lessons and we'll come out purged, cleansed because of that, and recognize and appreciate the thing that were before. I mean, just 2 months ago, we were free to move, we were free to travel, we were free to meet, we were free to go to the to do shopping, to go to restaurants, to do all of these things. We cannot do all of these things. We cannot even go to masjid to pray. So alhamdulillah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been kind to us, and we want him to be more kind to us and forgive us and make this month a month of great blessing for all of us. Let us remember some people who are not well in our dua, and some people who passed away. Brother Muhammad Dawood Simji and Brother Asad Bukhari, they passed away. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them maghfirah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them and give them Jannah and give patience to their families. Request from Saadia Yunus. Her parents are not well, especially her father. Probably has this virus. And also Dr. Muhammad Yunus, the ex-president of ICNA, he is also suffering. So make dua for their health and make dua for the health of Brother Rafi Muhammad and Brother Haitham Bundukchi and anybody there are a lot of people who are not well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them shifa. May Allah make them recover, especially those who are suffering from this virus. May Allah remove this pain from them and give them full health, a speedy recovery, inshallah. Allahumma shfi maradana wa shfi mawtana wa ahtim bis salihati a'malan. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-afwa wal-afiyah wal-ma'afat al-da'imah al-fawza bil-jannah wa najata min al-nar. Rabbana la tu'akhidna in nasina wa akhtana. Rabbana wa la tahmil alayna isran kama hamaltahu ala al-lazina min qablina. Rabbana wa la tuhammilna ma la taqata lana bih. وَاعْفُ عَنَّا وَاغْفِرْ لَنَا وَارْحَمْنَا أَنْتَ مَوْلَانَا فَانصُرْنَا عَلَى الْقَوْمِ الْكَافِرِينَ اللهم يا حي يا قيوم برحمتك نستغيث يا حي يا قيوم برحمتك نستغيث يا حي يا قيوم برحمتك نستغيث أصلح لنا شأننا كله أصلح لنا شأننا كله ولا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين ولا أقل من ذلك والله the most the living one oh, one who controls everything. We are asking you, we are seeking your mercy. We are seeking your mercy, Allah. Allah be merciful upon us. And do not leave us, abandon us to our own efforts, to our own selves, for any moment, even for the twinkling of an eye or less than that. Allah, help us. Allahumma aghisna, Allahumma aghisna, Allahumma aghisna, Allahumma ansurna. Allahumma inna na'udhuka min jahdi al-bala, wa min darak al-shaqa. ومن سوء القضاء ومن شماتة الأعداء رب اغفر وارحم وأنت خير الراحمين اللهم ارفع هذا البلاء اللهم ارفع هذا البلاء عنا وعن الإنسانية وعن البشرية رب اغفر وارحم وأنت خير الراحمين رب اغفر وارحم وأنت خير الراحمين وصلى الله تعالى على خير خلقه محمد وآله وأصحابه وأتباعه أجمعين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين